in order to cause a by-election. To that we say no. We've got ministers, a lot of them, who would bounce back. Let's say John Malanji is a minister, he was a minister. We have Ronald Chitotera, he was a minister. What we are saying is, let us not persecute people in order to cause by-elections and try to grow a party in a region where it is weak. If anybody was corrupt, if I am corrupt and there is a case, please go ahead and bring it forward. Arrest me and persecute me, but do not persecute.
All right.
Number two, my expectation is not that when people now jump from PF into UPND, then they get immunity. I'll give you an example. On social media, some of the alliance partners who have joined UPND, the alliance partners, some of them were being accused by UPND media that they rigged previous elections. Today, no one is talking about them as having rigged previous elections. So that is the evidence that we want. And we want those same people to be arrested, even if they're on that side. This is the Zambia that we want. This is what we'll be doing as an opposition party that is responsible, advocating for the rule of law, asking them to publish reports that they are claiming that we never published. Jackson Kungo, our provincial chairman,
quickly, Mr. Kiwom,
was murdered. That is one of the first reports that I want to see, and I've not even heard a single statement from the president-elect.
That's youth-oriented, youth-focused, and youth-centric. So what do I mean exactly? It doesn't matter which party is constituted in parliament, is constituted in cabinet, or which presidential candidate is at state house. Our task remains the same. Regardless of who is in power, our task remains the same. What we're trying to do is we take full acknowledgement that Zambia has got a very large youth population. Statistically speaking today, out of every 10 Zambians, 7 are going to be categorized as a youth between the ages of 15 and 35. But when you look at the dissolved parliament, for instance, the parliament before the parliament that's coming up next, there was only 1% youth representation in the entire parliament. So to us, that's where our red flag is heightened.